Thank you, Prithvi, for joining us. It's really a privilege for me because I know for us as Swasti as an organization, the Karur Textile Manufacturers and Export Association was the first industry association to sort of agree and front end the cluster model that we've been talking about. And we have been talking about it for nearly 18 months now. And it was earlier this year that KTMEA came forward and says, yes, we will, you know, this is something that we want to take forward. So tell us a little bit why, from your experience, because you're not only an owner of a company and running a business, but also secretary of the association. So if you can share with us what the thinking was, why the association was willing to do this, I think it'll be interesting for other associations in other places.
Yeah, first, thank you for this session, and it's a privilege for me to be part of working with Swasti in the initiative for well-being of the employees. So why we took this initiative at our factory is basically to address the health issues which otherwise wouldn't be even realized by our employees, and the consequences are perennial one, like they are not well, or they are ill-nourished, or anything related to their ill health. It directly reflects on the productivity, absenteeism, loss of efficiency, attrition, and so on. We have so much of work-related issues. So when we thought we should do something about it, and when we learned about Swasti's initiative, I thought this would be a very good intervention where we could leverage the experience that Swasti has in this domain. And with this implementation over the last couple of months, we could realize the benefits out of it. We could understand how many employees in our factory are anemic and hypertension and other issues. And we are able to address this, and we could feel a very encouraging response from the employees also. Like when I check with my people, they are very optimistic about this. I get very positive feedback from the employees. Then I thought this should also be communicated to our fellow exporters who are also having the same kind of problem with their employees. Mm-hmm. So whatever good practices that we practice or we enjoy, it's I thought it's my duty to communicate with other exporters also, and this will in turn help them to practice the same kind of initiatives in their respective factories, and this in turn will have a very positive and very progressive kind of environment in Karur space.
Right. One of the things that I've heard, and correct me if this is wrong, right, that at least in India, companies or some businesses think that why invest in people if, for example, there's 5 people leave, 10 people leave, so what, there'll be another 5 or 10 who will come and work in the factory. Is it actually that, do you think that there is that kind of a mindset, and that is probably why not everybody is willing to necessarily make the investment in their people?
Maybe that was the thought before, but I don't think it is still prevalent, because there is shortage of labor. People who hire migrant laborers and employees to work in factories. So we are now more focused towards retaining the employees, providing them with better facilities in order to attract them towards employment, and retaining them in the factories and so on. So I think maybe they are not aware of the benefits that arise out of this intervention. Once this message is conveyed to them in a proper way, I think no factory will hesitate to implement this program. So what Swasti charges in my case, I felt it was a very good deal because hardly it matters because even if some of my workers go to a hospital or for a single visit, probably they pay this amount what is being paid for the whole year you know, with Swasti. So I don't think this nominal fee is going to be a matter anymore.
So I think we're clear that companies want to invest, and there is a desire for collaborative action, right? And I think one of the reasons that a lot of companies come into associations or form groupings is because there is opportunity for collective action, right? What you can't do as individual companies, you can probably do as associations, which is why you have the Karur Textile and Manufacturers Exporters Association. You, as that, this association has already taken this step by endorsing this model and saying it's good for our association. So that's the first step. For other associations who are out there wondering whether you should be looking at such interventions, what advice do you have? What is your message to them, right? Whether it is in Tamil Nadu or for, I think, the rest of the world.
See, the very objective and purpose of association is to you know, protect the interest of the members. So reaching out to the members with good initiatives and good interventions like this will definitely help the members directly. So when we took up this initiative in our association, and when we spoke to our president, he was readily willing to, you know, even provide some space for the clinic in the, you know, textile park. So having realized the benefits out of this kind of intervention, we are very much willing to share our experience and the benefits that we have derived out of this to other people as well. Definitely, once these concerns are addressed, we are going to have a better productivity, a lesser absenteeism, lesser attrition, a positive mindset among the workforce is going to directly benefit the factories, which in turn will benefit the entire industry. So we'll be happy to share our experience and the thought process with other associations also.
And you do think that when we're talking about collaborative action, the association can play a significant role in actually not just informing members, but also probably, and I think that is where we still have to develop this a little bit more, but because we're talking about action between buyers and suppliers, but the associations sometimes get left out. What is the role of the associations is sometimes not clear. But in what I hear you saying is that there is a role for associations, and that may need to get carved out a little bit more as we move forward.
Yeah, definitely. When this is being imposed by the customers, then there is a very, very minimalistic or no role for the association to play around. But when it is being initiated by the respective factories, or when there is a common problem like, you know, lack of labor or lesser productivity or higher absenteeism among workers, then that becomes a problem for the industry. So this is where the association can intervene and, you know, give the right kind of guidance to its members, like, you know, educating them about such initiatives, which will in turn benefit the members. So maybe if not very actively, association can, you know, take up these kind of initiatives whenever there's a necessity or whenever we encounter a common problem in the industry.
Right. No, great point. Thank you so much, Prithvi, for joining us and for this conversation.
Thank you very much.